Hi, Joe Mazumdar again with Exploration Insights at the 2017 Vancouver Roundup. And many of you probably understand that we've been looking at early exploration plays, district scale plays that we think that majors would be looking at because they're not doing an exploration. So one of the plays we're looking at is Nighthawk Gold. Nighthawk Gold is in the Northwest Territories. And here we have Mike Byron, the CEO. Hi, Mike.
How you doing, Joe? Pleasure.
Could you tell us a little bit about your project, the Colomac project?
By all means, come on in and we'll walk you through the poster because that's basically our presentation. We'll quickly cover it in a nutshell. But yes, we're in the Northwest Territories of Canada, about 200 kilometers north of Yellowknife. Access is by an all-weather road up to this point, and then it's a winter road that the territorial government puts in to access some First Nations communities in the north. But it happens to cut right through the middle of our property. We're fully permitted to run splays off that onto Colmont and have in the past. Just a little update that recently the federal government and the territorial government have committed to making an all-weather road up to the Wati. So you're within 90 kilometers of our project site. And if you take a look at this picture right here, you'll see all this mine waste rock. There's about 70, 80 kilometers of waste rock here that would be laid down for roadbed. So if we can get to that point where this becomes a viable economical deposit, we have some synergy here that we can work with the territorial governments and the First Nations communities and build all-weather access into a site. And that's critical.
And so for our audience, they got to understand that Colomac was an old open pit, a lower grade than what you're finding now, but that's all been cleaned up, and that liability is nothing to do with you now.
That's correct. That liability is maintained by the federal government of Canada. That's who we bought the asset off of in 2012. And when that happened, all the underlying royalties were also stripped off the asset. So it's 100% free and clear. There's no earn-ins. There's no option payments. There's nothing. It's a very clean ownership scenario we have in the territories. And as a former producer, yes, it was in production up until the 1997. The company that had it went bankrupt. So the resource reverted to the federal government. It took them almost 10 years to clean it up. And by that time, everyone had forgot about the asset. And that was the key thing when I started looking at it, was I understood, my God, I mean, this is a Kalgoorlie analog. And by that, I mean, it's a differentiated mafic sill and had never been recognized as such. And then the key for me was Kalgoorlie has a history of high grade and Colmac never did. So as I said to a lot of people, it's either Colmac doesn't have high grade opportunities or they were never looked for.
Right.
And the cold reality is no one ever looked for them because we've demonstrated they're there, and I'll walk you through that. But we did have a resource the first year we acquired the asset. So we did put out a maiden resource at the time in 2013. And that was based upon only one year's program of drilling. And I've highlighted these here for everyone to see. And when we acquired it in 2012, we drilled a little over 11,000 meters. And that allowed us to validate the resource, to get it into a compliance status so we could put out a national instrument 43-101. But also, it gave us something to talk to the marketplace about and a place to begin to tell the Colmac story. In 2014, we had a modest program on Colmac and we drilled some more. 2015, a very small program. Last year, we had a nice program, a little over 8,000 meters.
When did you start hitting the high grade?
High grade in 2014, at a time when there weren't too many eyes on the story. But that validated our proof of concept that this thing did have the high-grade opportunities.
And when you say high-grade, like we're looking at a resource of 1.6 grams, what are your intersections, high-grade intersections look like?
Yeah, probably the best one to show you is this section, which is 1603. So we drilled that this year. So this was a 25-meter hole that we drilled north of the discovery hole. So we're getting 72.65 meters of 5.58 grams. And with a sub-interval of 17 meters of over 18 grams. This is not typical Colmac rock.
Right.
And what I can tell the audience is when we discovered this, we had to demonstrate to everyone, and ourselves included, that it wasn't just a one-hit wonder. That this thing was actually a domain that had boundaries that we could actually treat as a distinct sub-deposit inside of our deposit. So we stepped out and drilled and defined the dimensions of zone 1.5 as being 125 meters in strike length, 30 to 50 meters in true width, from surface down to 260 vertical meters and wide open. And I think that's the key, because if we look at where those intersections were in this long section, There's the past producing open pit, and here's zone 1.5. We were less than 100 meters north of it. No one knew about this, or they would have taken it out when they had this thing in operation. So that told me a lot about the opportunities that were left here. One thing, too, I want to talk to people about, because this is the first place we're going to drill this winter, is this area in here. And why I want to do that is this is zone 1.5, and this is zone 2.0. They're two high-grade zones that sit side by side within 100 meters, but no one's ever tested to see whether or not they merge and coalesce. If they do, we could be looking at a domain that's upwards of over 300 meters in strike length, 30 to 50 meters in true width, and again, down from surface down to depths that open. Now, we haven't drilled this yet, so this is what I want to do and test that, because that could change the true nature of Colmac in a big way. Right?
So Kinross did a private placement in you late last year, or the middle of last year. So what's their interest in the project?
Kinross were the first group that came and understood the Kalgoorlie analog before the word escaped my lips. And that's so that gave me a lot of confidence that we were going down the right path with what we saw. And they have experience, some of the geologists at Kinross have experience working on the Kalgoorlie deposits in Australia. So they saw that connection. But more importantly, they understood the value of the regional land play. Because now when you look at what we had staked back in 2010, 11, and 12.
And how big is this land package?
This land package is roughly 60 kilometers by 20 to 25 kilometers wide. So it's a big footprint. Colmac sits in roughly in the middle, and all these little icons express areas that we had worked before acquiring Colmac that all shared one thing in common: high grade and shallow. And that's something that I check off on my little box of opportunities when I'm looking at it from my geological perspective. Is our Archean gold camps do have the diversity of deposit types. We have that here. Gold and iron formation, our orogenic load gold, gold and debrecciated gabbros, and of course Colmac and differentiated sills. So it's telling me the system's robust, it's active, and it's far-reaching, and it's enriching itself over time. So now we have this overlooked multi-million ounce opportunity with all sorts of strike length and depth extent to explore, sitting side of camp with all these satellite deposits all within a few hundred meters of surface. So it's a pretty cool land position, and it's a pretty interesting play to have.
So in your history of drilling to date at Colmac, I understand like this year, you've got how much of working capital?
We've got around $15 million.
So you're well-funded, and this is going to be your biggest program to date in 2017.
This will be by far our biggest and most ambitious program to date. We will be active throughout the camp. We will be active at Colmac, and we'll be testing more areas of the Colmac sill as potential high-grade candidates.
So in terms of an investor, and we're investors, so what can we look forward in terms of catalysts for the next 6 to 12 months?
You're going to get a lot of news flow because we'll be drilling a lot. We're going to get a lot of news out on first off, delivering whether or not these zones coalesce, and that'll be a big point for us, but also testing other zones. You're going to get a resource update later in 2017 when we release all the drill results. We've already initiated a metallurgical study, and that results will be coming, it will be in our hands by late 2017 as well. So
and I guess we got to understand with the metallurgy, this was an old mine, and the metallurgy at the mine was very good, but they never got to the high grade, so you just want to make sure that the metallurgy is similar
exactly
to what that they mined before, which was really good.
Yeah, we want to be ready before we take the next step and say, do a PEA or something down the road. We want to have all our ducks in a row, and we want to understand the true nature of the ore at Colmac, both the low grade, both the high grade, both the near surface mineralization and both mineralization at depth, so that there's no surprises down the road.
Okay, thank you very much, Mike.
Pleasure, Joe.
We don't like those kind of surprises. So that was Nidoc Gold, a district scale project in the Northwest Territories. Why we like it is the high grade. And what we're going to look for is a lot of catalysts with the drilling to see if they can repeat those grades before. So we'll continue to hold Nidoc.